It's the oldest trick in the book. A bunch of guys turn up in hi-vis saying they've got excess bitumen and they'll do your driveway for a cut rate. But the work is rubbish or the price explodes and you've been scammed. Well, Greg smelled a rat and called us. The sting is sweet.
They said, oh, we've got a deal for you. We can come and bitumise your driveway for a reduced price.
Tonight, the sting these door-to-door salesmen never saw coming.
You're being stung, brother.
The driveway standoff.
Are you the bitumen bandit?
No, certainly not.
You're not?
And the mechanic who turns the tables, leaving the accused scammers empty-handed.
They were definitely in a hurry to get out of the place.
What's wrong with the work that we've got?
Tell us why you're running away then.
Go current affair.
Rewind to the day before when two men arrive at this repair shop on the Gold Coast asking to get some work done on their car. Except they weren't regular customers. These men had an ulterior motive.
They had excess product left over from a prior job, and they'd do a really cheap price at $25, and it's usually $55 a metre.
Owner of Night and Day Auto Care, Greg Sharam, says he agreed to an initial quote of around $2,000. Within minutes, workers wearing hi-vis show up and the job to bitumen the driveway begins. It's all hands on deck, carrying out what looks like a professional job, CCTV capturing their every move.
And then he walked back in probably about 2 hours later and said, oh, you're up for $6,000, when can you pay?
But Greg was already one step ahead, telling the man he couldn't pay him until the following morning when the account staff are back in the office.
It was one of Greg's staff members who alerted him to the scam he'd seen on a current affair. So Greg decided to call us to arrange a sting and turn the tables on the men.
I'd actually convince them that I'd pay them today at 9:30, 10 o'clock, hoping that I could get the police here in time or current affair in time.
When they return to get the money, our camera crew is there, ready and waiting.
You're being stung, brother.
Got the film crew in this morning.
Yeah, too right, because you're that scammer, mate, the bitumen man.
Watch the alleged scammer try leave as he realises he's been sprung.
Scammer, mate.
Your scammer's here, mate.
Are you guys the bitumen bandits?
As the man tries to avoid our cameras, things take a dramatic turn. He's met with a four-wheel drive as Greg's staff attempt to block the exit. The men then abandon the car and flee on foot.
This is a joke. I'm having a lawyer on this.
Do you think the work that you've done back there is decent work?
It wasn't prepped right, it wasn't rolled right.
Do you think anyone in their right mind would pay $6,000 for this?
No. No way in the world. I wanted it in the front of the doorway to stop all the dust and all the dirt coming into the office, but it's actually worse. We're carting all the gravel into the office because it sticks to your front shoes.
Would you like to say anything to the business owners?
When we return to the workshop, the man calls Greg, denying he's a scammer.
So we all get tied with the same bus, eh?
No, prove that you're not them and I'll pay you the money, mate.
The men never showed, but police did.
They basically said it's a civil matter and they couldn't do anything about it.
They did, however, review CCTV inspecting the machinery and vehicles used by the men. The white car wasn't theirs, but a hire vehicle, the company coming to the workshop to collect it.
He's not going to get more work if he keeps doing work like that.
And since we began investigating, a legal letter sent to a current affair identifies the man in our footage as Mr. Robert Peachy, the director of Premium Bitumen Surfacing, stating it's his company that carried out the work for Greg. The company website has three testimonials, including one from a woman who is a journalist from Washington, D.C. A reverse Google image search reveals identical testimonials appearing on five other websites owned by companies run by different people, offering the exact same services. A search of the business addresses on each website returns some unusual locations for a bitumen company, including one of Sydney's most prestigious sites, Chifley Tower, a Queensland holiday park, and a virtual office.
Oh, hi, Ashley. It's Jess calling. I was just wondering what sort of work you guys do. Is it bitumen work?
I'm not too sure.
When we rang each of the business numbers, we couldn't get a direct line to staff.
If it sounds too good to be true, it usually is. So don't pay anything up front. Make sure you get a quote in writing with the trader's name and address, and always ask to see a licence.
Queensland's Attorney General and Justice Minister Shannon Fentiman.
I urge Queenslanders to report any bitumen bandits or dodgy behaviour to the Office of Fair Trading. We can help Queenslanders get their money back, but more importantly, we can also fine these dodgy traders.
Last year, Mark Jackson, who owns a smash repair business southwest of Brisbane, fell victim to a similar scam by different men.
He said, I've worked it out. He goes, it turns out to be $52,000. What? $52,000? I don't have that sort of money.
In Mark's case, that salesman became aggressive, standing over him, demanding he cough up the money.
To the point where I had to hand my phone to them and show them that I had only $8,000 in my account, where they just got the phone, transferred it across, and then that was it.
Greg is one of the lucky ones because he didn't hand over any cash.
The legislation needs to be changed to cover people.
We are onto it. We are fining people. So my message to them is stop this dodgy behaviour.
Go home. Go back to England. Go back to Ireland where you come from. We don't want you over here.